By whom we every day may receive adoption, look presently upon your beloved son and daughter, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and everlasting inheritance. From our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is in heaven with you, in the unity of your Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you, son of man, I have appointed watchmen over the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me. If I tell the wicked, O wicked one, you shall surely die. And you do not speak out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall surely die, but I will hold you responsible for his death. But if you warn the wicked, trying to turn him from his way, and he refuses to turn from his way, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save yourself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, owe nothing to anyone except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments You shall not commit adultery. You shall not kill. You shall not steal. You shall not covet. And whatever other commandment there may be, are summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no evil to the neighbor. Hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, if your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Amen, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst of them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Once upon a time, two brothers who live on adjoining farms fell into conflict, and it was the first serious rift in their 40 years of working together. And it began with a small misunderstanding, and then grew into a major difference, and finally exploded into an exchange of bitter words, followed by weeks of silence. One morning, a carpenter came knocking on John's door. I'm looking for a few days' work, he said. Perhaps you would have a few small jobs here and there that I could have worked with. Yes, said the older brother, I do have a job for you. Look across the creek at that farm. And that's my younger brother. Last week, there was a meadow between us, but he took a bulldozer and dug a small river between us. Well, I'm going to do it in one bed. And see that pile of old lumber. I want you to build an 8-foot-high fence between us. And then I won't need to see his place or his face anymore. The carpenter said, hey, show me the nails and the tools, and I will do a good job for you. So the older brother went into town and then later returned to seek no fence at all. Instead, the carpenter had built a bridge that stretched from one side of the river to the other, wood hand rail and all. And his younger brother was coming toward him. His hand outreached. You are quite the guy, he said. After all I have said and done. And two brothers met in the middle. They shook each other's hands and they turned to see the carpenter leaving. No, wait. Stay a few days. I have a lot of other projects for you, said the older brother. I would love to, the carpenter said, but I have many more bridges to build. So this story echoes today's gospel sentiment. True reconciliation over separation. So with Jesus coming, he ushers in a new way, in a new way of resolving personal conflicts through compassion and mercy. As his followers, we are to be like the carpenter who builds bridges, not fences. If the Heavenly Father can show mercy to mankind by giving us Jesus Christ, we can learn to do the same. Because our soul depends on it. And we hear of a similar warning in the first reading also. In reality, it is easy for people to get angry, pissed, and throw a punch as we see in today's society. Rage is already on the rise in the world, and we shouldn't be adding more fuel to the fire. Remember that anger and hatred also have a negative effect on you emotionally and psychologically. Then you can't eat, you can't sleep, and can't be productive. And in turn, become weaker and sicker. The longer you hold these negative emotions. So why would you want to put yourself through all that when there's a bad solution? Our faith reminds us to be more like Christ and follow God's way. In the end, the world will be just, and each of us will be just by our Creator. He will not ask how many fences we make, but he will ask how many bridges we build or try to build. It is not impossible. You make an effort and trust in the Lord's way. Ask yourself, do you want to live a life of being bitter, angry, and resentful all the time? Or be the latter who uplifts and the most of life, making lemonade if he is given a lemon? our faith tell us that we always have a choice when it comes to doing what's right and wrong. And Jesus Christ, our Lord, and our Eucharistic celebration is a daily reminder to follow the light in Him and not this world. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, He was crucified upon His pilot. He suffered death, was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. My brother and sister, let us pray that all humanity may reflect the mercy and love of God in seeking reconciliation and unity among all people.
For our universal church, that it will walk together in unity under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those leaders of countries who disregard human rights, that they will refrain from the use of repression to control their citizens. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For reconcilement between family members who continue to hold grudges between each other. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewed commitment to follow the commandments that our Lord set out for us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have a single-minded love for money, that they will become generous givers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and who are dying, and for those whose names are written in the St. Jude Book of Intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Pacifico Alan Gomez, the Vasilina, Victoria Pulse, Mark Norcutt, Diego Alberto Garcia, Andrew Borrecchio, Sandra Turnbull, and Patrick Johnson. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the repose of the souls of Francis and John the Tall, for which this Mass is offered, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Confirm, O God, in unity and truth, that just you gather in Christ, so that bound together in mutual love, our prayer may be pleasing to you and bring us the protection. We ask it through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's join us singing our offertory hymn found in your white songbook, number 92, Shine on Us, number 92.
Oh.
Pray, my brother and sister, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his church.
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by protecting the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, that you might love in us what you love in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to the gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, and as in exaltation we acclaim. So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time of betrayal and willingly into passion, he took bread and given thanks, broke it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more given thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Given thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you, humbly we pray that, partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered unto one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your just breath throughout the world, and bring that fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and with the Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and of thy mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle, and all who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, Sister Yah, Apostle of Peace, I leave you my peace, I give you. Look not on our sin but the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
How far do you
make vows unto the Lord your God and accomplish them. All you gather around him to present offerings to the awesome God who takes away the life of princes. He is greatly feared by all the kings of the earth.
God is renowned in Judah.
In Israel, his name is great.
His tent is set in Salem,
and his dwelling place in Zion.
It was there he broke the flaming arrows,
the shield, the sword, the armor. Takes away the
Let us pray. Pray that your faithful, O Lord, whom you know is in the life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who is and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
We sit for a moment.
This morning, no matter our age, God is calling us to grow in our faith and our love for Him. Here at St. Jude, we want to provide you with a variety of opportunities to do so, to do just that, starting this week. On page 4 of the bulletin, we have information for our RE, our religious education, Emmaus, upper room. For adults, please see page 5 for a list of all of our fall studies that are starting this week. Our monthly Allen's Ministerial Alliance Luncheon will be on Tuesday, September the 12th at 11:15 a.m. It is a great time of food fellowship and entertainment for those ages 55 and older. Many of our events here at St. Jude, involve the kitchen by serving others by providing food. If you work with a ministry that uses our kitchen facilities or are interested in serving any of the other ministries that have food-related events, please consider becoming kitchen trained to ensure that the proper guidelines and requirements are being followed. For those interested, training will be provided on Thursday, September 14th at 7 p.m. in the kitchen. St. Jude will have the St. Vincent de Paul collection truck here next Saturday and Sunday from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. Find the list of items you can donate on page 7 of the bulletin. Attention, all students, grades 5 through 12, altar servers are needed for all masses. Especially we need altar servers for the Saturday 5 p.m. and the Sunday 8 a.m. mass. Signups and training will be held Sunday, September 17th, following the noon mass. If you are interested, the training will team you with an experienced altar server and mentors to learn how we actively participate in the weekend masses. And I'm going to put in a personal note there that without this group of young men and women, that this mass would not go as smoothly as possible. So let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. For those families participating in our at-home study for religious education program, there will be a meeting on Thursday, September 21st at 6:30 p.m. in the educational building. Please come to the information meeting to hear about the changes to the program and to pick up materials and books. St. Jude is hosting a gathering for all Catholic homeschooling families. Join us on Friday, September 22nd at 12:30 p.m. following the noon mass. Please RSVP with the number of adults and children who will be attending so we can plan accordingly. And the deadline to register for that is Monday, September the 18th. As you can see, the carnival is happening in the South Field today from 3 p.m. to 10 p.m. Those of you that were able to make it out here yesterday, I think it was a great day. The weather cooperated, it wasn't quite as hot, but I think we had a great and wonderful day. But it's still going on this weekend on Sunday, so come join us for that aspect of it. And finally, 10 a.m., the Cub Scouts and the Boy Scouts are hosting their donut ministry this month. Head on down to the parish hall after a mass for some coffee and some donuts and this fellowship. Get to know your other parishioners here at St. Jude. And that, we thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing the first and last verses of hymn number 630, Alleluia, Sing to Jesus, number 630.